right, we are headed towards the shootout. The Zambonis are just heading off the ice after the dry scrape. And then we will find out who Paul McClain and John Tortorella have selected as their shooters. One thing I can tell you, it'll be Alfredson, Silverberg, and Turris for Ottawa.
In that order.
And we have yet to get the list from the Rangers.
Again, a lot of time for the captain on the ice. Right now,
Gabrick, Callahan, and Stepan will be the first three shooters for the New York Rangers.
Another game of over 20 minutes, 21-13 for the captain, Alfredson. You're thinking about shooters. You're thinking Silverberg is already beaten. Probably the best goaltender of all time, and Brodeur in New Jersey in a situation just like this. A lot of people would argue that Lundqvist is not far behind, and he was beaten by Silverberg. Shorthanded backhand. The young kid has got a lot of confidence.
So we'll see which way they go. Both these teams have been in two shootouts this year. Both these teams are 1-1 in the shootout. The historical advantage, though, definitely goes to the New York Rangers. Since the shootout came into the National Hockey League, they are 51 wins, 37 losses, which is the fourth best record in the National Hockey League since the institution of the shootout. So everyone appears to be ready.
Well, coaching staff seems to be happy to get a point out of this one. It's a mighty test. You know, I mean, listen, Neil Smith on the old Sportsnet panel earlier talked about the fact that the Rangers are a much better team than what they've shown of late. This is a big situation for a team like the Senators, missing their top players. They're now in the shootout and they're guaranteed a point. See if they can get two.
Here comes Alfredson. Line doesn't fire. And it gets to the goal line before Lundqvist realizes it, then steers it away.
I don't know how close this game to actually crossing, but it seems as though Lundqvist had lost sight of the puck and then picked it up just before it went past the goal line.
Here comes Marion Gabbert. In on Bishop. Gabbert slows down, cuts in, and Bishop makes the save.
Boy, Bishop is really tremendous with that hockey stick. That's one of the things he does so well. He gets that down so he covers the five hole. And that's exactly where Gabrick was trying to go.
Jakob Silverberg. Pete Brodeur. Pete Lundqvist.
All right, chalk it up. Brodeur and Lundqvist twice. That is not easy to do. I don't know if there's ever been a rookie that has done anything like that. Powered it.
Ryan Callahan, one in regulation. Forehand scores!
That is a great shot. Callahan, who is strong and the captain in this hockey game. That's a big shot.
Kyle Turris now. Chris wanders in, delays, and a save is made by Lundqvist.
Solid glove save.
The game now will rest on the stick of Stepan.
Now shooting the Rangers number 21, Eric Stepan.
As Stepan scores, this thing is over. Stepan wanders in to the forehand. Save is made by Bishop. We're going to extra shooters.
Another glove save by the big goaltender, Ben Bishop. You know, everything is about patience and waiting out the shooter. And you see there where Bishop did not make the first move.
Zibanejad scored in regulation time. Here comes the 19-year-old. Zibanejad cuts in, backhand, and missed.
Swedes are involved in this game. Amika trying to go top shelf or anything on the left side, had it roll off the end of his blade. Always tough to try and make it deep on the back end.
Richards can win it here. Richards speeds up, his shot misses. Let's go to shooter number 9.
Now Shane here, Senators number 15, Zach Smith.
Interesting selection here. Zach Smith hasn't scored a goal in 30 games.
But back to March 2-12.
Here comes Smith. Does he do? Misses high.
I have to think that this selection is partly the way that Coach Paul McClain coaches. If he were able to score on that, take that monkey off his back. Not scored a goal, Zach Smith. March of 2-12. As we said, how many games is that?
30.
Yeah.
Here comes Hagelin now. Hagelin on the forehand, the lays backhand, and he misses high. Shooter number 11.
Wow.
Patrick Weirkosh.
You know what? He's found a way to get his wrist shot through from the point. Let's see if he can do the same thing and get it through on this.
Weirkosh takes it wide. Moves in, backhand, misses high.
I don't know. I tell you, I would really hesitate to go on my backhand at any time in a shootout when you're not practiced at that art.
Here's JT Miller. Leading his way in, Miller on the forehand, stops and still misses the net.
He missed a wide open net. He missed a wide open net. That puck either rolled off the end of his stick or he just missed. Oh.
Barking here at Scotiabank Place of Eastwards. Dogman slowly in, backhand, scores! The off-speed pitch.
You know what? That's the excellence of goaltending that you have. It has to be something like that to beat these goalies. Oh, he was going on the forehand.
That would have been a really great goal had he meant to actually do it.
I know, but it counts.
Here's Kreider now. Heading in. Misses. Ottawa wins it.
Yeah.
As Bishop gives Kreider the wave after Kreider took out this team's starting goaltender, the best goaltender in the NHL right now. They celebrate this game. But tomorrow we'll find out the condition of Craig Anderson.
And a lot of congratulations for Ben Bishop, and well, they should. He comes off the bench cold. And when you mean cold, you mean he's been sitting there for 4 hours since warm-up at 7 o'clock. Well, not quite that long, but for him to come in and be as sharp as he has been, kudos to Ben Bishop.